locations in the United States. So that means there's always a hot battery in each defense location. That means there's people sitting on the radar waiting, watching. There's the missiles are armed. People are sitting here waiting. All you have to do is pull the safing plug, put the arming plugs in, the missile can be on its way. You're within 2 to 5 minutes of firing a missile. The hot battery has 4 missiles up waiting, unless it's inclement weather, and by that is thunder and lightning. I'm sure David's told you to get those boosters to take off, to ignite. It takes 9/10 of a volt to get them to start up. That's why we didn't like lightning. Also, when you're pushing the missile from here to the remote launcher by the Falcon, there's 2 more over there. The minute you get it to the launcher, first thing you do is you hook up the grounding strap. No static charges. The first check you pull with the voltmeter is for stray voltages. One of the other checks that's done on the missile is somebody's got to hook up the squib connector for the 4 boosters to the launcher. Pull out the safety plug of that, and you actually take the squib connector and the launcher connector, and you put them together. It's not for the faint of heart. Not every cook off, but if they did, you'd be dead. Because, like I said, flames come out of the rear 300 feet, sound pressure goes up to 150 decibels. If you're going to fire a missile in here, nobody's above ground. Okay? You go to a blast-proof room right underneath where those 2 ladies, one in green, and the pink and black, right underneath there, there's a blast door where they would go to fire the missile. Any questions? Like I said, this is a missile launcher on an elevator, but there's 3 more remote launchers, 2 on this side, 1 on that side, and behind us is the same setup again. There were 12 missiles kept here. Out of the 12 missiles, 10 of them had nuclear warheads. Did he explain about the guard dogs? Huh? Nothing about the guard dogs. 2 men authentication area. No one person's allowed the inner fence by himself. If you're caught in here by yourself, even though you're supposed to be in here, you're in the ID book. It takes 2 people with equal knowledge of the job to be performed or more. You're either shot, or they'll turn the guard dogs on. The guard dogs trained to kill you. They will run over, knock you down, and turn your throat out. The guard dog handler has to run over and the dog off. There's always a guard dog on duty, and there's 3 more over there. The guard dogs have to be subservient to 1 person they're trained with. But at 1 time here, all 3 of the guard dog handlers were put in the hospital by their guard dogs. Okay? What happens if the dog handler transfers out? The guard dog has 3 months to warm up to another human being. If they don't, they're put down. Any questions? Yes.
That's what happened in my
head. There's a launch crew here. They'll be in the blast room. After the launch, if they launch 2 remaining missiles downstairs, they can work and not service the missile. They can arm the missile below ground, is what they would do if you were the hot battery and we were going to fire the missiles. Then those missiles over there would be up. So they'd fire the one over there, and they would rotate that. But also the other batteries in the San Francisco defense, they would be standing up and coming up in status. But you would come to a point where the hot battery goes down to the service battery, it's called, or maintenance status. So people are gone off on leave and doing other duties. So you might have the guard dog and guard dog handler being assigned to help launch the missile or do the work or at least push it down to the remote launchers and stuff. If the worst comes to worst, but that's the beginning of World War III, and we don't really want that. That's why we're here doing all this stuff. Not that we're paranoid, but there's 290 sites throughout the United States. 44 of them were ready to go 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. So that was from 1958 to 1974. They were taken out of service through the SALT I and SALT II treaty between us and the Soviet Union. Okay, any other questions? Okay, we'll bring the missile down. We'll take you downstairs into the missile magazine. You want to take pictures coming down? 3, 2, 1. about 110 square miles, so you have booster control, people control, and aircraft control.
27,000?
Yeah, 27,000. The United States likes to spend money on you.
What's the range?
100 miles.
People in there are going,
they didn't have any sites. They had the Volmark system, and there was up in Sault Ste. Marie, and the Volmark had about a 400-mile range, a bigger warhead, and we had given it to the Canadians, and then the Canadians said, you're going to be exploding what over whose territory? And they said, no, wait a minute. And they go, there's nothing. And the United States Army go, there's nothing up there. And they go, well, there is people, and moose, and polar bears. And they go, you're going to be exploding what? Where?
They were going to create a missile. They were going to call it the A.
So the theory was that they would blow up a ship, I guess.
A ship, slow incoming aircraft.
So when they were nuclear, I guess I think it would be massive. Is that what
the whole idea was. Soviets had a bomber to carry the nuclear weapon that was 35 to 42 megatons, not kilotons, million tons. Think of that fan as 1,000 pounds or equivalent. Now think of 35 to 42 million. Hiroshima and Nagasaki had 20 kilotons.
I was going to make it a career too until my wife said, we get out or I get out.
Take cookies down.
Cookies down.